everybody. It's Miss Dorothy. I'm back for another episode of Goodnight Lighthouse. I'm here to read you a bedtime story, and I am so excited about this bedtime story. You know how we've been reading a lot of books written by Syd Hoff? He wrote the Oliver the Elephant book. He wrote all our Danny the Dinosaur books. And now we found another book written by him, and it's called Sammy the Seal. Sammy the Seal. This is Sammy. He's a seal. And I wonder why he's out there on the road with these kids. Shouldn't he be in a zoo or in the water or something? That's where seals are supposed to be. That's interesting. I wonder what's going to happen in this book that takes him out into the world with all these kids. Well, you know what we have to do. We have to open the book and find out how Sammy got out into the road and what happens. Because I think he needs to be in a zoo. But we're going to have to open this book and find out what's going on. So you want to get in here with me and find out about Sammy the Seal? Good. I want you to sit up, listen up, and pay close attention, because here we go.
It was feeding time at the zoo. All the animals were getting their food. Wow, they're bringing in a lot of food, but I guess zoos have a lot of animals. The lions ate their meat. The elephants ate their hay. The monkeys ate their bananas. The bears ate their honey. They look pretty happy with that. When it was time for the seals to be fed, Mr. Johnson took them fish. "Hooray for fish," said the seals. And they jumped in the water. Soon the basket was empty.
"That's all there is," said Mr. Johnson. "There is no more."
"Thank you for the fish," said the seals. "They were good."
The seals were happy. But one little seal was not happy. He sat by himself. He looked sad.
"What is wrong, Sammy?" said Mr. Johnson.
"I want to know what it's like outside the zoo," said the little seal. "I want to go out and look around."
"All right, Sammy," said Mr. Johnson. "You have been a good seal. You may go out and see."
"Goodbye, Sammy," said the other seals. "Have a good time."
"Goodbye," said Sammy.
"Where are you going?" said the zebra.
"I'm going out," said Sammy.
"Have fun," said the hippo.
"Come back soon," said the giraffe.
Sammy walked and walked and walked. He did not know what to look at first.
"That seal must be from out of town," said a man.
Sammy looked at everything. He's even looking down the hole at the men who are working underground.
"What street is this?" said a man.
"I am a stranger here myself," said Sammy.
"I guess it's feeding time here too,"
said Sammy, looking at the people in the restaurant.
"That is a lovely fur coat," said a lady. "Where did you get it?"
"I was born with it," said Sammy. "I wish I could find some water. I am hot. I want to go swimming," said Sammy.
"We are sorry. There is no room for you in this puddle," said the birds.
"And there is no room for you in here," said the goldfish.
"Keep out," said the policeman. "You cannot swim in there."
Ah, here is a place, said Sammy.
Who is in my bathtub? Said someone.
I'm sorry, said Sammy. And he left at once.
He climbed in the window and got in that man's bathtub. That did not make that man very happy.
Some children were standing in line. Sammy got in line too.
What are we waiting for? Asked Sammy.
School, what do you think? Said a boy.
That will be fun. I will come too, said Sammy.
The teacher was not looking. Sammy sat down. The children made words with blocks.
Look, they spelled out the word cat and the word dog.
Sammy wished he could spell. His blocks don't make a word.
All right, children, said the teacher. Now we will all sing a song.
The children had good voices.
That sounds fine, said the teacher. But one of you is barking, just like a seal.
Is it you, Joey? Said the teacher.
No, said Joey.
Is it you, Helen?
Said the teacher.
No, said Helen.
Is it you, Dorothy, Robert, Fred, Joan, or Agnes?
No, said the children.
Then it must be you, said the teacher.
She found Sammy. He was the one barking like a seal when they were singing.
I'm sorry, this school is just for boys and girls.
Please let me stay, said Sammy. I will be good.
All right, you may stay, said the teacher.
Sammy was happy. He sat at his desk and looked at the teacher. He learned how to read.
He learned how to write.
He wrote his name on the board. That says Sammy.
And now it is playtime, said the teacher. Who wants to play a game?
We do,
said the children. They threw the ball over the net.
The ball must not hit the ground, cried Sammy's team. Somebody catch the ball.
Sammy caught the ball on his nose. A boy on the other team tried to catch the ball on his nose, too.
Boys must catch with their hands, said the teacher.
He probably hurt his nose. He's not a seal.
Sammy tried to catch the ball with his flippers.
Seals must catch with their noses, said the teacher.
Up and down went the ball from one side to the other. At last the teacher blew her whistle.
Who wins? Said the children.
It is even, said the teacher.
Everybody was happy. A bell rang. School was over.
Will you be here tomorrow? Said the children.
No, said Sammy. School is fun, but I belong in the zoo. I just wanted to know what it was like outside. Now I have to go back.
Goodbye, Sammy, said the children.
We will come to see you.
Good, said Sammy.
Sammy was in a hurry to get back to the zoo. He had so much to tell the other seals.
May I welcome you home, Sammy, said Mr. Johnson. I'm glad you're back. You are just in time for dinner.
There's no place like home, said Sammy.
He was very happy to be back at the zoo and getting his fish for dinner.
Well, how do you like that? That was a really good book. So it turns out that Sammy asked the zookeeper if he could go out and see the world, and the zookeeper said yes, and Sammy went out and had all kinds of adventures and made all kinds of friends, but then he went back to the zoo, and he says, "There's no place like home." And that's true. It might be fun to go visit places and meet new people, but the best place to be is at home. I love being at home. You know what else I love? I love that there was a little girl in this book named Dorothy, just like me. It says right here. Is it you, Dorothy? There's not a lot of books with the name Dorothy in it. That made me feel kind of special. I kind of liked that about this book. It's always fun to hear your name someplace. But Sammy the Seal was a good book, and I really enjoyed reading that to you, and I hope that you enjoyed listening to that. But now, my little seal, it's time for you to flip her off to bed. It's not time to go out into the world and see adventures. It's time to be home, tucked in your bed, ready for a good night's sleep. But before we go off, let's thank God for the homes He's given us. Home is such a wonderful place. It's where our family is. It's where we can feel safe. Let's thank God for giving us our home. Okay, will you pray with me? All right, fold your hands and close your eyes. Dear God, thank you for this special, special day. Thank you for how you love us and all you've given to us. Thank you for our homes. Thank you for the houses we live in and the family that lives there with us. Thank you that we have a home to come back to every single night after we go out and see the world. Thank you for our families, our moms, our dads, our brothers and sisters, and all the people that love us. Watch over everyone tonight. Give them a good night's sleep. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, little seal, I want you to flipper your way over into bed, curl up under those covers, and get ready for a good night's sleep. I'm going to be back to see you real soon, but until I get here, obey and obey right away. Show Mommy and Daddy how much you love them by how you obey them. And I'll see you real soon right back here on Goodnight Lighthouse with Miss Dorothy. Bye.